let's think about the binary search algorithm. You're given a sorted array A containing, let's say, n unique elements. Then, given a target value v, you want to find the largest index I such that a sub I is at most v. You can find this index by binary search. To compute the number of cache misses, you'd set up recurrence like so. Once the search interval falls within a cache line, there would be just one cache miss. Otherwise, you pay for one miss plus any additional misses to search the remaining half of the array. Solving the recurrence, you'd find the following. Big O of log n over L. Compare this to the lower bound. Binary search differs from the lower bound by about a factor of log L. So it's not optimal, but one nice thing about binary search is that it's already cache oblivious. It makes no references to the cache size Z or the line size L. But it begs the question, how do we get to the lower bound? In fact, there's a way to do it. Leave the logic of the binary search algorithm intact, but change the data layout. Remember that a binary search tree maintains some ordering of its elements. Let's number this tree according to an in-order traversal. If you interpret these numbers as addresses or index positions, then the layout of the tree nodes is equivalent to sorted order. But there's nothing sacred about this layout. In fact, let's consider a different ordering, which is called the Venom Dubose layout. I'll sketch this now, but if you want some details, see the nice tutorial by Eric Demain. The idea is to use the following recursive layout. Suppose you start with a complete binary search tree. If it has about n nodes, it should have log n levels. Now divide the levels in half. So there would be about 1/2 log n levels above the cut line and about 1/2 log n below. This also means the upper subtree will have about root n nodes. Below the cut line, there will be about root n subtrees, each of size root n. Here's the Van Emdebose layout idea. You have a binary search tree that you'd like to lay out linearly in slow memory. After partitioning the levels, lay out all of the upper subtree elements together, and then concatenate them with the lower subtree elements. And when I say lay out the elements together, I mean recursively apply the Van Emdebose layout to each subtree. So, what does this buy you? Let's zoom in on the tree, looking at the point where the subtrees fit within cache lines. That is, in the figure, the elements in each of the smallest subtrees shown fit within a cache line size, L. A binary search in this tree takes some path from the root to the leaf. Since the subtrees are of size L, you only generate a cache miss when you hit the root of one of the subtrees. Now the maximum height of one of these little cache line size subtrees is log L. So, starting at the root of the tree, how many of these size L subtrees will you visit? Well, the height of the tree is log N. So, on any path from root to leaf, you'll encounter log N over log L subtrees. That's totally awesome, because that is optimal. Woot! The important lesson is that data layout matters. What we did here that was so cool is we took the standard binary search algorithm, reshuffled how we stored the data in order to get an I/O optimal algorithm, and the layout is itself cache oblivious.